Welcome everyone to YRS Production Series Live, episode number 179. After a delay, the powers that be, we had installed a new remote access program app and tested it. Everything was fine, and when we actually went to use it, it found out it didn't work with XSplit, which is our broadcasting program we use in conjunction with Facebook, which is our broadcasting, as you know, our host to broadcast. So once again, this is the second time that we still don't have a screenshot of my computer, but I'm going to proceed anyway. Apologize for the delay. Also, as everyone should know by now, we're all under quarantine, which is what our last song was. That was the subject of our 178. It's actually called Quarantine. And we're still there, so we have canceled our live audience until further notice. So it would be invite only this particular time. It's just me, and thankfully I didn't have a lot of people here waiting to try to get our screenshot going so you can see what's going on as I'm working on it. So I'm just going to have to tell you what I'm doing, and I guess use your imagination what it looks like. You listen to 178. We had Richard Ashford on vocals. He wrote the melody and the lyrics. Three of the harmony parts, actually all of the harmony parts were, you got to hear this, all of the harmony parts were generated by Cubase. So here's Richard.
Not like the eyes I've ever seen, but it's still
And here's one harmony part.
Not like your ears I've ever heard, not like your eyes I've ever seen, but it's still a quarantine.
That's the alto part. Here's the tenor.
Not like your eyes I've ever seen, but it's still a quarantine. Not like your ears I've ever heard,
and then here's the soprano.
Not like your eyes I've ever seen, but it's still a quarantine, not like it is I've ever heard.
That's all Richard's voice.
I've ever seen,
copied three times and transposed. Then we did the individual letting in on the transposition of each one to come up with this arrangement, vocal arrangement.
A quarantine,
the drums, the program, of course, Groove Agent I use. Steinberg Groove Agent is native to Cubase. We use 10.5.12 is the latest version. This particular kit is called Aberdeen. I thought it sounded pretty good. That's better? Okay. All right, so the drums, Aberdeen is the kit. The bass was Hallion Sonic, I believe. Yep, Hallion Sonic, and this particular patch is in a second. Come on, open that for me. Dry finger bass. There's a synth in here. This was Retrolog, and this is called Wood Peck, Wood Park, Wood Peck, Wood Peck, P-E-C-K, from Retrolog, also native to Cubase. How's the balance? Okay. Damn. Vocal. Okay. Oh, okay, good. Okay, so let's go. Woodpeck from Retrolog. Remember, there's 8 virtual instruments in Cubase. They've all got some very cool stuff. There's not much filler in there at all. It's very usable. We use the... let's go to the flute in here. I'll have that lady give that a listen. Let's go to the verse section. I'm selecting on the arranger track the area for the segment for the verse. P for part puts the locators at the beginning and at the end of your selected segment. And here's the verse. On the verse, there was also a Rhodes in here. Here it is. Playing a little melody there. Also a nylon guitar. Let me show you what that's playing. And also in there is a Strat, clean Strat. Okay, let's get out of this guy, and I have an idea for this. I'm not going to save that because I already did, so Control W, don't save. Control N for our new one, PS179, 179er. I have an idea, don't have a title, but I do have I have a little vocal idea, and lyrics anyway. And I thought I had kind of had something in mind for the, here we go, come on, for the drum pattern and kind of the song in general. Here we go. All right, so I'm gonna use the G drive, my external USB drive, and the folder is Curious Projects, come on now. Come on, Nelly, is there something running in the background here? What do we got there? Oh, Master Writer, yeah. Okay. There we go. Come on. Right, I guess. Curious Projects laptop. I want to use the default location. That's what it is. Use the default location. There we go. Q. Cubase Project Laptop PS1, PS 179, I believe, right? Yeah. Okay. There we go. G Drive Cubase Project Laptop. All right. So I'm going to start with a drum beat. I'm just going to kind of get the feel first, and I'm starting with a hi-hat. Okay, here's our default template. If you don't have one, excellent idea to get one going. And if you're not sure exactly how to do that or what in the heck is a default template, you can contact us here by whatever means you like. And we'll give you the info. We'll even help you out. And if you pay us, we'll do a remote access and set one up for you. Well, actually, accessing your computer so you can be right there and see how we're doing it. It can be kind of a tutorial as well as a time to, you know, set up and configure everything optimally and also for your preferences. So when you start it up, most people are used to a blank screen. And, of course, you have to think, oh, I'll just add the tracks when I need them. That wastes time. If you had a configuration set up with your preferences, with some of the sounds maybe you use, some of the plugins that you use, the dynamics and so forth, that would be ready. And you could start, if you had an idea, you just start playing. So that makes a lot of sense. It's much more efficient. And the idea that, oh, I can just add that quickly, I can add a track when I need it, that is a step that you can avoid simply by having that prepared at least somewhat in advance, so that your progress is uninterrupted and you become much more efficient in your production and, of course, a lot more efficient too. So I'm going to go to the drums, pick a drum kit. I want to start with the hi-hats, get a pattern going with the hi-hats. Let's see. The last time we used Aberdeen. So let's see what we got here. I'm going to go up here and take a look. What do we got? And we want to use the instruments, not the patterns, because we're going to make our own. And I look for a drum kit, an actual kit, that I haven't used before. Okay, so let's see what we got over here. Aberdeen was the last one we used. And let's take a gander. Aberdeen, okay. So we're at the top. 29-minute Jupiter, what the heck is that? They've got some very unique names in here. I don't know who thinks of these, but doesn't seem to have anything to do with the actual sounds of the drum kit. I've asked before, I will repeat, if you have any clue as to what these names that they are giving to these drum kits, what they mean, I'd love to hear your interpretation. Okay, let's see. So it's there's Aberdeen. And what is this one? Add what? Intron. Addy Love. Ageless Alive. What is this Addy Love business? Let's try this one. Let's see what it sounds like. Whoops, I'm sorry, did that knock me out of focus there? Am I all right? Okay. Okay, that sounds pretty good. Oh yeah, I like the kick. Snare's good. Fine. Side stick? That'll do. Toms? Where's the hi-hats? It closed. What do we got here? Hi-hat pedal? Okay, closed. Hi-hat pedal open? Open. There we go. I'm going to use this kit. Sounds pretty. I like the kick. Oh, yeah. Notice when I play a little bit softer. And I want to give it a good whack. Nice. Velocity scaling. There's in this particular kick, it has five different samples. So each velocity range, going from really soft to loud, has a different sample. Let's see if I can trigger it from here. No. 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 But that's. That'll do. That will do. Let's assign it while we're at it right now. So in the kit, in order to have each drum assigned to its own individual audio channel on the mixer, needs to be assigned. It isn't originally by default out of the box. So you have to select a drum kit. In this case, it's Addie, A-D-D-I-E, Addie Love. Addie Love. Like addicted to love, maybe? I don't know what Addie Love is. Anyway, so more or less in the center of the screen at the very, very bottom, there is, when you point to it, it says Output Bus. Yay! Or you can click on the right mouse button on the pad. In this case, I'm using the very first pad in the lower left corner, and I can select Assign Output. And it brings up the list of all 32 audio outputs that you can choose. In the drum agent, of course, whenever you have an agent, that's the drum kits that actually show you a image of the drum kit. Those are limited audio outputs, and those can be assigned to the Cubase main mixer, but only, is it eight of them, I think? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, that's it. You only get eight. Eight assignable outputs. Now you can also assign those to an additional, another eight buses. They're bus outputs. They're not actually, channel outputs, audio, yeah, they're buses, but anyway, I'm not sure they're the same output on the VST, on the main Cubase mixer. So I tend not to use those because I haven't figured out how to use all 32 outputs. I don't think you can. Correct me if I'm wrong, but these are a lot easier to use. So those ones with the image, the kits with the image, the drum agents, they sound really good because they've been processed, had effects and so forth assigned to them, but they do not have as many outputs, and I don't think you can assign any more than eight actual audio outputs to the mixer, to the Cubase mixer. I think that's it. So I'm definitely going to use the standard kits, not the drum agent kits, and assign those drums up to 32 audio output channels. So on the mixer, you can have the kick, snare, hi-hat, tom 1, tom 2, etc., 32 of them. Pretty sure that you're going to get all your percussion instruments and everything in there in 32 outputs. Any drum kit with more than 32 individual instruments is pretty massive, and you'd have to admit pretty unusual. So here's the kick is on one, also called the the master. Okay, number two is the they call it cross stick. I'll put that on two. Output two, audio output two on the mixer. These are the audio outputs that I'm assigning. The first snare is D1. Pretty good. I like it. Three. Number four is snares off. I don't use it very often. I'll go ahead and assign it, just for the heck of it. Okay, there's four. The rim shot is five. Rim shot five. Okay, now here we go to the hi-hats. Closed hi-hat. Hold on. Pedal hi-hat. I'm going to move that right now. Pedal hi-hat right now is on F1, and I want this to be on G-sharp 1. So I'm going to move that. I'll just click and drag it over, because it's in order from C to D-sharp 2. C, C-sharp. This is the first octave on the keyboard, MIDI keyboard. So it's two octaves lower than middle C. On MIDI considers middle C at C3, but an actual piano, an acoustic piano, is C4. I hope that's not too confusing. If it's MIDI, they use C3. So C2, two octaves below middle C, or three octaves below if you're using the acoustic piano standard, it'd be three. But anyway, C1 is assigned to the kick drum. And what was I saying here? Yeah, so F, the pedal hi-hat was on F1, and now I'm moved it to G-sharp 1, which is general MIDI assignment for the drums. The hi-hats are F-sharp, G-sharp, A-sharp, first octave. So that's why I'm moving that pedal over there. Closed hi-hat is on F-sharp, so I've got the snare already. The rim shot on 5, assigned to 5. I'm going to put the closed hi-hat next on 6. And I'm going to put the pedal hi-hat, G-sharp 1, on 7. I'm going to put the open hi-hat, A-sharp 1, on 8. There we go. Now the toms would be next. Oh, what do you got here? What? Ooh. Get a dumb back here. Check it out. Oh, I like that. Oh, I think I want to use that. Put that in the snare department, perhaps. In fact, right after the rim shot, which is E, I'll put that dumb back over on F1. So right after the rim shot, which is E1, I'll put the dumb back. Okay, and that's, what is that? It's 8, that should be 9. I think the open hi-hat was on 8, yep. And 9 for the dumb back, 9, okay. There we go. Then we got some toms here, let's see. Pretty high. It's like a mid, not really low, but it's low enough. Okay, I'll put the tom 1 over here on G1. And that would be, 9, that would be 10. Audio output 10 on the Cubase mixer. 10. Tom 2, I'll put it on A, and that would be 11. Is that correct? Tom 2, Tom 1, 10, Tom 2, 11. Good. 13, 14, 15, uh-oh. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Okay, I think I got it. That's 11. Okay, good. 11, what do we have here? A couple of crashes. Okay, I just put those in the order that they were, that they fall in. So 11, this would be 12. 12 for one crash. 13. Oh, holy Toledo. I'm so sorry. Beg your pardon. It's only a sneeze. It wasn't a dry cough. I have no temperature. I'm pretty fine. Good health there. Okay, where am I? Right. That was, this one was 12, 13. 13, there it is. 14, 14, 15, ride cymbal. 15, and 16 for the bell. Come on. 16, there we go. Righto, 15. Yeah, 16. Now, once you do this, please remember to save it. Otherwise, you're going to go through it all over again. So this is Addie Love, and just to the right, up at the top where you select from the library, there's a little icon. If you point to it, it will say Save Preset. So I'm going to type it in exactly the same way it is here, Addie Love. ADDIELOVE, one word, Addie Love. Okay, and let's save that again, make sure that I am actually overwriting it. Save preset. Addie Love, there it is. Yep, Addie Love, perfect, guys, it's there. I'll save it again, though. Addie Love, perfect, override, so I know I've saved it. Okay, excellent. Here we go. Let's get out of this guy. And we're on the main screen here. Okay, now, make sure I don't have any. I can get a little bit better there. On the delay, let's get some. I'm going to set this. I'm going to go to the control panel and set my buffer size. There we go. Right down there. Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah. Let's try that. Excellent. There we go. That sounds pretty good. Okay, let me get the feel first here. Tick, 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 tick. I can barely hear that. I'm going to bring that up where I can't get my, I really can't get the feel here. Go to the mixer, and my, oh yeah, I can barely hear that sucker. This guy's a little bit loud. This guy can be a little bit louder. So I'm going to the gain up at the very top. It's under, they actually call it filter or pre, and you can open that guy up. And there's a gain in there. So now I have, now I can hear the pedal hi-hat. Turn that one up just a bit so I can work the dynamics. Excellent. And what's the open hi-hat sound like? Probably loud. Oh yeah, as always. What happened? You're okay? Oh my gosh. What? You're surprising yourself? We're on closed caption now.
Over there,
what the heck? Oh my gosh. This is weird stuff happening. Oh, really? Oh my gosh. Do we have the, what, so we got somebody doing sign language over on the side? Oh. The reply to that was, George, remember there's nobody here. We don't have an audience. Yeah, okay.
Okay.
Okay, I'm going to try some. Let's do the metronome. Doo-ba, doo-ba, doo-ba. That's maybe 90. Let's see here. That's too fast right now. That sounds pretty good. Okay. Okay, I'm gonna try it. Now it's triplets, please. Sixteenth notes, is that right? Am I in the right okay, let me find one that fits, please. Okay. Okay, I'm in the drum editor now. Okay, move this guy over one. Okay. Okay, should go here. Oh no. Okay, I'm going to work with this one right here. Get rid of this. These two. And move this over. What are you giving up on, Pam? You what? Oh, on your phone? Okay. I don't know. Okay. All right. I get it now. Okay. So nothing too major. Zoom in on this. Come on now. Dup, dup, dup. No, dup, dup, dup. Dup, 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 dup. Oh, got it, got it, got it, got it, got it. What's that? Really? What? Words are coming up?
Yeah.
You're kidding.
No.
It's being interpreted?
What you're saying is coming up.
Really? Oh my gosh. In English, of course.
No.
Oh my gosh. Well, this is really great. Yeah, you know how I've prepared. I've really greatly prepared for this. Yes. Yeah. Put up, up. Put up, put up, put up, put up, put up, put up. Yes, I did. Come on now, come on, come on, come on, come on. Oh, I know. I'm gonna put this back up here. There we go. And dip, dip, da. Move it over. Okay, this one. This needs to be here. There we go. All right. One more. I'm gonna base a beat around this pattern here. Okay. Missing that. Let's move that, copy that guy over here. Control D. Right here. Oh yeah. And this one. Round B, please. Need another one right here if you don't mind. Go. Looking good, looking good. We heard somebody said something?
No.
Oh. Okay. All right. Oh. ba-dum-bum. Ba-dum-bum. No, the other way. We need maybe something down, right there on the feel, like down, I think. Oh, maybe this note here. No, let's try it. Too loud, too. Oh, that Dumbach, where's that? Oh, that's it. Boom. That does sound very good, though. No, maybe just do that. Okay. Wait a minute. Maybe. Oh, maybe another side stick. Hold on. You like that or no? I don't think a kick's gonna do it. That sounds up, I think. Fine without it, I think. You okay with that? Okay, it's good beat there to start with. That's gonna be our beat there. So you see, I started with the hi-hats on that. I kinda got a little groove going there with the hi-hats, and then put the got the beat going on top of that. The accents of the snare. All right, now let's call this as it's only a four measure phrase, so I've got to see what we can do with the music here. I'm going to select those four measures, two times two measures, T for part. There we go. Then we got one segment there that I'm going to call. There's four beat phrase. Okay, let's see now. Maybe I could do a bass here. Thank you. how to know. Something before that I really like, and wonder if I can. Where am I? Am I on six? Yeah. Oh, holy Toledo. Didn't like that for some reason. I don't know why. What? Uh-oh. I think you can't see the screen. All right. All right, here we go. Yeah, I'm gonna try another, perhaps, here we go. I used Retrolog last time. I found something on there, it was pretty good. So maybe I'll try Prolog. Retrolog's cool, but I'm gonna try Prolog this time. I don't use it much, so just for a change, something different. Let's see what we got. Prolog, oh yeah. Come on, Prolog over in this department. So I'm in the inspector, in the Apple routing box, I'm putting Prolog. Let's see what we can find here. Plenty of sounds. Lordy. 5 miles up. No, what do we got? Add mantra? What? Ambush, oh gosh. Angry God, oh brother. Would that be appropriate for this time? Angry God, maybe we have an angry God up there. Apple Fields, lovely. What does that sound like? Oh. Strawberry Fields forever. Oh my God. Oh my gosh. Apple Fields, I have to remember that. It'll come in handy. We want to play Strawberry Fields. Is it still giving it, printing out the words there? No? Oh, too bad. Okay, here we go. Axe. What is that? Fancy. No. What? Oh, wow, that's too cool. Auto-generated captions. How cool is that? Christmas, what do you got? What? Bip? Oh, please. BP Super. What the? Oh, please. Come on. Do not. Bright side. Here we go. Look on the bright side. Here we go. Bubble wheel. Bug screen. Bug scream. Oh, yeah, I want that one. Bushwhacker. Great. Oh yeah, that's got my name all over it. Bushwhacker. Let's see what that sounds like. Oh God. No. Bushwhacker, huh? What do we got? Here we go. Oh yeah, oh this is it. Look no further. No further. Here we go. We have two to choose from. Chemical Waste or Chords Professional. Let's try the Chemical Waste first. Yeah, not good. Chemical Waste, no good. Chinese Wall, Chimes. Where's the other one? Clean what? No, Clean Recorder. Where was it? Chords Professional. Oh, yeah. Maybe an octave higher. Nice. This is a B-flatted version. Chords, strange. Thank you. Wow. Thank you. put that low note in there. Loud as heck though. There we go. Bring it up a bit. Yeah. Here we go. And that chord took forever. A little chord progression there. Oh my gosh. Okay. get a MIDI guitar in here. What's this one? That's keys, huh? Synth? I'm going to get just a regular old MIDI guitar. Where am I on? Put that in there? Oh, come on. I'm in the wrong one. Alien Sonic. Let's see. There it is. Whoop. There it is. Da-da-da-da-da. da, da. That's so close. There we go. Da, da, da. There we go. Come on. There we go. Da, da, da. Now let's try the bass. Thank you. triplets. Okay, I can fix that. There's two notes there. And these guys, please get rid of the overlaps, please. Delete polyphonic overlaps. Delete overlaps polyphonic. That's under length. This is on the editor, the piano roll editor. And boom, yeah, they're a lot cleaner. See what that note is. I'm not sure what note that is. I'll delete this one. Ba-ba-da-ba-ba-ba. Oh, I could double that. Ba-ba-da. Okay, this note is over one more over to here. Let's see how that sounds. Let's see this right now. Get this one out of here. This one right here goes in the beginning. Just repeats. Copy that. Go over here. So the beginning. That should do. Oh, that sounds pretty good. Oh, I like that. Oh, let's bring that up. Now, what do we got? Hold on here. Can I? Yeah. Ba-ba-da. Oh, that note's, whoops. It's the wrong note. That won't do. Let me make that note just a little bit longer, please, so I can hear it. A little bit shorter. And this one, tiny, tiny bit. That sounds like I can hear that. Da-da-da-da-da. Okay, maybe I'm nice and short. Really short. How short is this one? 83. Make it the same. Okay, let's see how that's going to sound. Bass is loud as heck. That pad thing kind of sounds sticking out there, but it's really prominent. So let me just try one thing here and then get in next section. Thank you. Can help, please? Try this right on. This is straight it. I think so. Yeah, it works. Not bad. That's a little hint of that pad in the background. Try this. Right in the beginning. I can work with this, just abbreviated version, started late, nobody's here, this is our quarantine, isolation, sequestered, stay home, broadcast PS179. So it's a little bit different. It's not going to be as elaborate or as extensive as we usually do. So now, I had some noise. I'm plugging in the microphone. How are the drums? My screen, you know what I was doing here. I'm gonna do another one of these. Again, I'm copying and pasting sections here. Okay, so I'll do this one. Oh yeah, there we go. And that's it. There's our song arrangement. And we go out on this. There we go. There we go. Short and sweet. Okay, let's see if I can come up with some lyrics and a melody. Where's Richard? Where is Richard Ashford when we need him most? Richard, you probably got all the lyrics written. I know. I know what you're thinking. Richard is usually here. He's rarely missed any of these live broadcasts. And I know he's sitting at home right now and thinking, I would have had that whole thing written in the first 15 minutes. I know, you're probably right. That's right. He could have sent him in, couldn't he? Oh my gosh. All right, well. All right, here we go. So, let me get my melody going. I'm going to hook up my mic at the same time. Maybe I better do a little have a little intro there. Pencil tool to draw in the intro. There we go. On the arranger track. Oh, no, 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 no. Don't, no, no, no. Do not ever transpose the drums. Oh, my gosh. Oh, lordy, lordy. Which one was this? Hold on. I gotta see where I was. Thank you. wouldn't have been watching over my shoulder there. They would have told me that. Don't do that. Don't ever. Don't transpose the drums. Holy Toledo. What's that guy doing? I'm going to make a little note for me here. I'm going to make a little map, arrangement map. I guess I'll call this A. Okay. If Mark McGee is watching, Mark, you did a great job with PS175, which I still haven't finished editing, but I'm almost done. And I'll send it to you. Sounds great. You did a great job on that. And you'll be happy to know that I'm using A, B, C, the section. The section B. Up five semitones. Back to A. And then up seven semitones. And that is five. And then back down to beginning again. One. Let me hear that little change and make sure I got it right. Maybe this is better. Okay. All right, well, the computer kind of did it for me. I'll stick with that. Intro, and man, that pad. Bubbling. My head takes me a little bit longer than Richard, but I think I'm ready. And I had something in mind too, that I'm just going to plug in and start going down. Something about. Now, the last one we did, PS178, was on quarantine. I guess it was called quarantine, right? And this one's really kind of the same thing, but it's more about perhaps, the whole thing, the whole coronavirus pandemic and how it's affected us all. Pardon? Up. sanitizer, man. Wasn't there something about sanitizer? Wash your hands. What's it was? Purell? Purell. What's another name? Okay, I want to work on this section right here first, please. Okay. All right, maybe I'll just do a scratch, and then we'll end it. Okay. Oh, yeah. Okay. Hold on. Well, here, I can just be, you can still hear me singing, right? So I'm just saying, take a moment. Have to take a quick break. Hang on.
Hey. Together, wash your hands. Keep your distance.
Around the world, this pandemic. Okay, set my levels here. Hey, here we go.
Down. Oh yeah.
huh? There we are. Everybody come together. Everybody do that. You let us take love. Oh, yeah. Everybody do your part. Keep your distance. Wear your hands and gloves. Oh, my. Stay at home, show compassion and love.
Yeah.
Everybody do your part. Everybody do your part. Take your brother's hand and show them that you care. No, don't touch hands. Not good. No touching allowed. Hey, yeah. Compressor looks good. Yeah, not bad. Come together, keep a distance. Wear your mask and gloves. Your part, stay at home, show compassion and love. Oh, yeah. Live and run. Wash your hands. Okay. All right. Anyway, this looks pretty good. Levels look good. I think I'm about ready here. Turn the level down just a little bit. Everybody, brothers and sisters. Something about we're all in this together. All this here. Around the world. Around the world. Around the world. Around the world. Open your heart. Around the world. No. Around the world. Do your part. Everybody the same as Odell. Anyway, this looks good. I'm ready. There's just some lyrics going. I'll get the ones I've got already. Come together. Come together. Was it? Come together. At a distance, where your mask goes. Come together, give a distance, wear your mask and gloves. Hey, oh yeah. Everybody, come together, everybody. Come together, keep your distance. I'll try again. Everybody. Come together, but keep your distance, wear your, every, come together, keep your distance, wear your hats, hang on. Come together, keep your distance, wear your mask and gloves. Oh, yeah. Hey, everybody stay at home, show compassion and love. Oh, 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 yeah. Everybody, keep your distance, wear your mask and gloves. Do your part, stay at home. Yeah.
Everybody, keep your distance, wear your mask and gloves. Oh, yeah. Stay at home. Yeah, compassion and love. Everybody keep your distance, wear your hands, caps and gloves, dang it, says man up, do your part, show compassion and love.
I didn't write it down though.
Everybody keep your distance, wear your mask and gloves. Come together. Keep your distance, wear your mask and gloves.
Did you recognize that?
Come together. Keep your distance, wear your mask and gloves. Come together. Everybody do your part. Stay at home. Show compassion and love.
Mask and glove, compassion and love. Here it is again.
Come together, yeah. Come together. Keep your distance, wear your mask and gloves. Come together.
Everybody do your part, stay at home, let's show compassion and love. Come together, come together, keep your distance, wear your mask and gloves. Come together, everybody, everybody show, everybody, keep your distance, everybody do your part, stay at home, show compassion and love. Come together, keep a distance, wear your mask and gloves. Come together, everybody do your part, stay at home, show compassion and love. Come together, come together, keep your distance, wear your mask and gloves. Come together, everybody do your part, stay at home, show compassion and love. Come together. I got another verse. Okay, I'll do that one first. Oh yeah. Okay, here we go. Should be recording for me. Here we go. Rewind. Oh, I gotta be on the track, no wonder. There we go.
Together.
Come together, keep your distance, wear your mask and gloves. Come together, everybody do your part, stay at home, show compassion and love. Come together. You got it.
Section.
Do your part, stay at home, show compassion and love. Come together, come together. Keep your distance, wear your mask and gloves. Come together, everybody do your part, stay at home, show compassion and love.
Okay, so there should be another one of those, so I'm going to do that right now, and then we'll go into that last section. Okay? So now, one more verse, we'll call it a verse. Another verse just like that. Something maybe about the world you were saying. Right? About we're all in this earth together.
Let's do our part. No, we did. We said, come together, keep your distance, wear your mask and gloves. Okay. Everybody do your part.
Right.
Stay at home, yeah. Show compassion and love.
Right.
We only, let's see. We only have one planet. We're all
in this world together.
You are one smart lady. We're all in this world together. Okay, I'm going to let you think on that. I'm going to copy this over. There we go, got it. Okay, then we'll go into the... Yeah. Exactly, because I only have the one part right there, so I'll just do that one part. Okay, what time yet? Yeah, oh my gosh. Okay, we started so late. But let me see if I can do something on this end part here, and I'll leave this other one for this other verse. I'm just going to copy it over for the time being. Okay? And then... Yeah, like this. There we go. Just like this. Just like this. And this one too. So this goes back a little bit. Okay, so I won't do the other verse right now. I just copied it, so we have a reference. Okay, so it goes like this. Little intro.
Come together, keep your distance, wear your mask and gloves. Come together, everybody do your part. Stay at home, show compassion and love. Come together.
Oh, so that'd be different.
Keep your distance, wear your mask and gloves. Come together, everybody do your part. Stay at home, show compassion and love.
Okay, I'm just gonna sing a little melody there so I can remember it, and we'll wrap it up.
Buddy, do your part. Stay at home, show compassion and love. Come together.
Come together.
compassion and love come together.
Okay, I can't do it without you. So, you should be hearing me now, correct?
Yeah.
Okay. Delay? Perfect. Okay. Cover to that. Constraint, delay, compensation. Okay, I'm just going to do this little part here. Actually, because we are, let's go down here. There we go. I will sign off now. We got something to start with here. In fact, we'll go out with our handiwork. Let me just put a loop on this guy. And you can hear what we did. And I will finish up. I will add another verse. And then that little section here. I don't know what I want to call that. But perhaps a chorus or something. I don't know. Not a chorus. Maybe a... I'm not sure exactly what that is, but at any rate, we've got something going there. And for those of you that tuned in and joined us, thank you so much. I had it on good authority that remote utilities would work reliably. And we used it, we tried it out, it worked great. And then when we tried to use it with XSplit, it did not work. We couldn't get it going. So that really, we lost time and sorry, you couldn't on the computer itself on the broadcast because we couldn't get the screenshot up there. At any rate, thank you so much for you that tuned in, that were here with us, and this will be available on, of course, you can watch this on Facebook, it will be archived there. We don't save, we actually don't refer anybody there because the longer files are viewed best on YouTube. So we archive all of these sessions on YouTube. So if you go to youtube.com/YRSMIDI, you can find all of these. So this has been PS179. I'm George York. Thank you so much for joining us. Next broadcast, hopefully with a screenshot, maybe with special guests to see how things are going and what they will recommend for social distancing and so forth. We're trying to follow the guidelines. Special thanks to Pam Hanson, who did all of the show production and the video and audio engineering. So couldn't really have had a broadcast without her. So it's just Pam and I on this broadcast during the pandemic, 2020, April Fool's Day. And I hope we'll get a chance to have a live audience very soon. I'm sure everybody's hoping for that. So our next broadcast is the 15th of April. That is a memorable date because that's 2 weeks from today when they announced, you know, there's going to be a big deal in 2 weeks. We're going to have the, like, the apex of all this, the peak of everything. So that's a big deal. I'll be, everybody's going to be anxious to see what's going on with that. But anyway, until next time, that'll be the 15th of April. Thanks again. George York, signing off. Rock on.
Keep your distance where you're